kada mi je Damir u nekakvoj konzultaciji s njime, kad sam ga pitao što misliš, koji bi bio dobar pravac onoga što bi je trebao podijeliti.
In consulting consultation with Damir about when I was reflecting on what would be the good direction or kind of subject to cover.
Razgovarali smo i došli smo do neke teme evanđelsko usmjerenje crkve.
And we kind of agreed that maybe the good focus would be to focus on the evangelistic mission of the church.
I ja sam se tada razmišljao i tada i sada s kojim ja pravo mogu govoriti vama o evanđelskom usmjerenju crkve.
And I was just kind of thinking, you know, how can I talk to you and you know, what gives me the right to talk to you about the evangelistic direction of your church?
Jer ja sam vaš pastor bio ovdje prije neki koliko 15-16 godina.
I was your pastor here 15 years ago, you know, before.
Tako da par stvari koje želim podijeliti.
These couple of things I'd like to share with you.
Ne dolazi iz mog srca kako ja vidim stvari, stvarima koje meni znače.
They come from my own heart and from that which is I've discovered is significant to me.
A ne u želji da budem pametan na ovom mjestu.
And not with the aim of demonstrating that I've got this wisdom, you know, over anybody else about this.
Jer ja sam došao, ja ću otići.
I have I'm here but I will also leave.
Ali usput rečeno, što sam već prije rekao, radujem se što sam tu danas sa svima vama.
But in all, I want to just repeat again that it's a joyful experience for me to be here with you.
Zaista, kad sam slijetao u Melbourne, osjećao sam se kao da dolazim doma.
Yeah. When I flew into Melbourne, I just felt like I have arrived home again.
Da prvih nekoliko minuta uzmem i progovorimo o tome što je meni značilo i donosilo posebnu radost u ono vrijeme dok sam bio pastor ovdje.
I just want to reflect on that which was a joyful experience for me as I was the pastor and pastoring this church.
Imajte na umu da je to bila jedna velika kocka što ste mene pozvali jer ja nikad prije toga nisam bio pastor lokalne crkve.
I want you to just be aware that it was a kind of a risk for you to invite me because I did not have the pastoral experience of pastoring a church in
ja sam bio u Hrvatskoj pastor koji se bavio medijima i pisanjima u novinama i tako dalje.
You know, I was a pastor in the Croatian church, but I was more focused on the work of the church through writing and the media and radio and so forth.
Tako kad je te noći, jedne noći 1994. godine, mislim da to bilo proljeće, došao taj telefonski poziv, bio je to da nisam za mene.
And when I received that call early that morning, all those years ago, this was a special challenge for me, an invitation.
I mogu vam iskreno reći sada, ja sam bio sasvim uvjeren da ja mogu odraditi jednu pastorsku službu bez ikakvog problema.
And I felt confident that I could actually deliver and be the kind of pastor and I could deliver the pastoral service that was required.
No, međutim, tih 4 godine za mene su bile učenje.
But on the other hand, these 4 years of service here have actually been 4 years of learning for me.
I blagoslove tog učenja dan danas uživam.
And the benefits and the blessings of this learning that I've gained here and this experience have been demonstrated in my life at the present time.
Ali ono što je posebno mi značilo u tim godinama.
But that which stands out and had of great significance in all of those years.
I sjetimo se da su to bile, kao što to lijepo nazivamo danas, tranzicijske godine.
I want you to remember that the thing that was significant for me at that time, I want you to remember that these were like transition years as well.
Da, bez obzira na tranzicijske godine, događale su se tu lijepe stvari.
But despite the years of transition, but there were still some nice things that were occurring in this church.
Uvijek sam volio govoriti.
I always like to speak and talk.
I zbog toga uživao sam, ako se sjećate, bilo je tih pokušaja evangelizacija koje smo u Killeru imali i zatim u St. Albansku u kulturnom centru, ne znam kako se zove i na hrvatskom i na engleskom.
So you remember we used to have all of those evangelistic campaigns in Killer. I used to like to talk and therefore, you know, we engaged ourselves in the community.
I ako me memorija dobro služi, mislim da smo imali neka krštenja nakon tih mini evangelizacija.
And I recall that we had some baptisms also over these as a result of these mini missions at that time.
Bili su također i to nekakvi godine pokušaja nekog javnog nastupanja izvan okvira ovih naših zidova.
And it was also the attempt to kind of make some take ourselves and the message outside of these frames of this church and go out more into the public sphere.
Svjestan sam toga da ste vi to jako dobro razvili u svim ovim godinama poslije do jednog savršenstva danas.
I'm very conscious and aware that you have developed a lot of this work, you know, over these years. You have perfected it.
Na primjer, naš skroman orkestar, kad je par puta izišao i zasvirao u nekim drugim kontekstima gdje smo kombinirali duhovne pjesme zajedno sa, recimo, pjesmom Ne dirajte miravnicu.
Yeah, and there was some attempt. You remember that when we, as a musical, we use music to kind of engage outside in the community through the spiritual song, but then also some of those songs that had the cultural feel and fit for us as well.
I imala je ta crkva tada također ljubav prema ljudima okolo.
And this church, and through its work, there was a demonstration that there was a love for people who were outside of the walls of this church.
Još uvijek se sjećam energije i snage i s kojom je sestra Nada Huber vodila misionstvo u tim godinama.
I still remember the,
mislim da je misionstvo bilo,
yeah, the energy and the passion that sister Nada Huber used to run the evangelistic part of this church.
Sjećam se dok smo još ovu kućicu imali, koja je danas zamijenjena daleko ljepšom zgradom.
I recall that we had, when we had that house, you know, which was there present, that was replaced by this beautiful building at the present time.
I sjećam se s kojim je žarom brat Labaš vodio dopisnu biblijsku školu.
And I recall the passion of brother Labaš, who was conducting the Bible correspondence school.
Također sjećam se da smo i radili i za siromašne.
I recall that we also went into the sphere of working and helping, assisting the poor.
Jedno vrijeme čak djelovala, ne znam kako smo vi to zvali, ali bila je kuhinja za ljude koji su, recimo, nazvani beskućnicima.
We even ran a kitchen where and provided food for those who would be regarded as homeless in our community.
Još se uvijek sjećam s kojim je žarom sestra Marica Medlobi vodila to.
I recall the passion and the energy that sister Marica Medlobi had that for that part of the
world. Iza te kućice imali smo onaj ružni kontejner, ali imaju svoju svrhu jer smo tu držali dobra koje su nam trebali biti da bi spremili tu hranu.
And behind the church there was that container, but it provided a place of storage where we could kind of manage all of these sorts of front-end services.
Također, gostoprimstvo ove crkve uvijek je bilo na visini.
But the thing I want to say about it has been the welcoming spirit of this church was always on a very high note and very noticeable and valued.
Također se sjećam i uvijek sam zahvalan na tome koliko ste mi podršku dali, jer u meni je još uvijek u to vrijeme, ako sam bio pastor, srce gorjelo i za medijima.
And I recall the kind of support you gave me and encouragement you gave me to continue, because I still had that passion for the work within the media and using the media.
To su bile godine kad je ta eksperimentalna radijska postaja Melbourne Gospel Radio pokušavala dobiti dozvolu. Sjećate li se toga za rad?
And do you remember there was the time when the gospel, where there was this community gospel Melbourne radio was being experimented to kind of begin.
Visio sam na toj stanici koliko god mi je uprava dala vremena.
I used to be around that station, you know, as long as they were giving me time.
I nekad je to bilo 5 puta tjedno, neki put je bilo 3 puta tjedno.
Sometimes it was 5 times a week, sometimes 3 times a week.
Ali uvijek sam bio ponosan na onaj jedan program između ostalih koji je trajao pola sata na hrvatskom jeziku.
And there was always that opportunity which I was very proud was to work on this program that was being delivered in the Croatian language.
I uvijek je bio taj trik kako izvadimo taj program da ne namećemo adventizam, ali da u isto vrijeme ljudi znaju odakle to sve dolazi.
And we kind of, you know, how do we kind of manage to talk to people in a way that they don't feel as if we are bombarding them with the Adventist message, but at the same time that they know and understand what we are actually doing.
I onda ukvirima programa na engleskom jeziku.
And then in the context of the programs within the with the English language.
Uvijek sam lukavo pozivao za goste, da li iz Gilsola koleđa direktora ili nekoga iz konferencije ili nešto slično.
And I used to invite, you know, guest speakers from Gilson College and anywhere from everywhere else.
Jer tad je bila prilika da kažem da je riječ o direktoru adventističke škole ili ovome, pa gdje se čulo opet adventistički ovo.
And then, you know, I had always the opportunity to say a few words and introduce the speakers, either, you know, a principal of the Adventist College and so forth.
Jer nisam htio da ispadnemo nekako sektaški.
I didn't want to kind of go forward and felt that we kind of attacked people and declared the sectarianistic attitude.
Ali uživao sam da znaju odakle dolazi struja koja je bodila taj.
But it was very important for me that they also understood where we were coming from in the end.
I vi ste mi u svemu tome davali podršku.
And you had assisted me and helped me through this process.
Nitko nije nikada rekao, pastore, zašto gubiš toliko vremena na radiju.
Nobody said to me, pastor, why are you wasting all this time on the radio like
that? A onda i često, kad god je bila prilika, uskrs, Božić ili bilo što drugo, tu se i nekakva poruka progurala kroz hrvatske programe.
And remember that during Easter time and Christmas time, and there was always some opportunity to kind of pass the message through, even through the Croatian programs.
I onda kad je riječ o mojoj službi u tim godinama.
And if I'm speaking about my time here as a pastor and service at this time.
Možda nisam bio najbolji u posjetama.
Maybe I haven't been the best visitor.
Ali vjerujte mi, kad sam ovdje stajao, želio sam iskreno propovijedati evanđelje bez ikakve isprike.
But remember that when I stood here and wanted to preach and declare the gospel, it was a gospel that I wanted to deliver without any apologies, without, you know, without any difficulty.
I koliko se ja sjećam, to je jedino što sam propovijedao svoje propovjedonice.
And that's the thing I always used to proclaim to you, was the gospel.
Ne govorim to zbog toga da se nečim ja hvalim.
I say this not because I want to brag about this or demonstrate, you know, some pride in this.
Želim samo reći s time da sam uživao biti pastor u ovoj crkvi.
I just want to say that I had enjoyed being serving you as a pastor in this church.
A bile su te, dozvolite mi minutu ili dvije, također i godine tranzicijske.
Remember, it was also a period of time of those what we would refer to and talk about in terms of transition times.
Bile su to također godine kad, ajde da iskreno kažem, prošli smo i kroz jednu fazu međusobnih nerazumijevanja između crkve St. Albans i Sedon.
And there was, you know, we kind of went through some of these tensions, I guess, let's be honest, you know, between, you know, the various churches in Sedon as well.
Jer bilo je to posebno vrijeme.
It was an unusual time and...
Jer, ali mogu reći i to.
But I also want to say this to you.
Bez obzira što smo činili.
Without regard to what we were doing,
i ja svakako stojim na tome,
and I stand behind,
ništa nismo radili zbog toga jer smo htjeli biti hrvatska crkva.
We didn't do anything because we wanted to demonstrate that we are a Croatian church, so to speak.
Već smo željeli odgovoriti na poziv, da bi možda nekako mogli približiti evanđelje i ljudima koji se prepoznaju kao Hrvati.
The main reason was to be able to actually declare the gospel to the Croatian community that needed to hear this as well.
Da li smo uspjeli u tome ili ne, vrijeme će pokazati.
You know, whether we were successful or not, you know, the time always demonstrates that.
Ali dozvolite mi reći to.
But let me say this.
Meni je drago.
I'm very pleased.
Nakon svih ovih godina.
That after all these years.
Da koliko ja čujem i vidim.
And from what I see and hear.
Da su ta vremena prošla.
That those times have gone.
I da su odnosi korektni između ovih dviju crkava.
And that the conditions and our workings together in Melbourne between the churches are a lot more productive.
Jel tako treba biti?
And that's how it needs to be.
Jer bilo bi žalosno kad bi 20 godina nakon tih godina mi još uvijek se nadimali ko je veći Hrvat, ko je veći Srbin ili ko je veći Jugoslaven.
And it would be just, you know, that if we were gonna kind of who is bigger, you know, Croat, Serb or whatever.
To su bila ta vremena, tranzicijska.
That was the time of that, what we would regard as transition.
Što se mene tiče, nek tamo i ostanu.
As far as I'm concerned, let them stay there.
Još par riječi.
Just in a couple more words.
Jer okretali smo se ka unazad.
We kind of reflected back into the past a little bit.
Kako vidjeti budućnost?
How to kind of look forward and what
especially,
of the future?
Posebno iz te nekakve misijske perspektive.
Especially from that perspective of the mission and evangelism.
To svakako je nešto što je u vašim rukama, ne u mojim.
Obviously that's something that you hold in your hands, that determination is in your hands rather than mine.
Ali ono što bih ja želio vama kao netko izvan koji još uvijek voli ovu crkvu.
But I want to say something to you as somebody who cares about you and who knows you as an outsider.
Da, broj jedan, volio bih vidjeti da je ova crkva utemeljena bez isprike na evanđelju Isusa Krista.
And I just want to say that I want to see, I would love to see that this church continues to be grounded and founded on the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Čuli smo to više puta tijekom današnjeg dana.
We have heard today this repeated several times.
Držati se Krista, imati Krista u središtu svega.
Having Christ and holding on to Christ and having Christ at the center of all things.
Jer bez toga,
without that,
što god drugo radili,
whatever we do other than that,
je samo predstava.
It's just some sort of show.
Zatim bih volio reći sljedeće.
This is what I'd like to say next.
Volite se međusobno. Oprostite jedni drugima ako imate šta opraštati.
Love each other and forgive each other if you need to and have something to forgive.
Nitko od nas nije savršen.
None of us are perfect beings.
Ja sigurno nisam.
I can declare that I certainly am not. And I do too.
Učim se što sam stari.
I learn as I grow older.
Da ako ljubim Isusa Krista,
that if I love Jesus Christ,
a ne učim opraštati i voljeti,
but I don't learn and I'm incapable of forgiving and loving,
da je onda moja lojalnost evanđelju lažna, prijetvorna.
Then if I don't do that, the loyalty that I declare to Christ is actually a false and a lie.
I neće biti uspjeha u evangelizaciji prema drugima ako ovo nije prvo sređeno.
If there will be no success in passing this gospel message to others if this is not our real experience.
Zatim bih rekao, imajte na umu mlade.
I'd just like to say secondly that keep in mind and keep your focus on also on the young people.
Jer crkva bez mladih je mrtva crkva.
In reality the church without youth is a dying church.
Što god to značilo u ovom kontekstu,
whatever that means in this context,
prilagodite se tome da mlade zadržite u crkvi.
You know, undertake whatever you need to do in order to keep your young people with you.
I zatim, kad je sve ovo na mjestu,
and then when all of this is in place,
nastavite služiti onima koji su oko vas.
Continue to serve those who have needs in your community and who sit around you.
Počevši od onih koji su tu možda u kućama okolo crkve.
You know, maybe begin with people who are living around in the houses just in your neighborhood.
Služite zatim cijelom St. Albansu i kako god se nazivali ove općine i gradovi okolo.
And then go out into the wider community, all of St. Albans and you know, other areas.
Neka ovi ljudi znaju da ih vi volite.
May those people know that you truly love them.
Neka ovi ljudi znaju da ne mislimo da smo mi pametniji od njih.
That they realize that, you know, may they know that we are just not smarter than them all.
Neka znaju da ne misle da mi smatramo da smo sami sebi dovoljni.
That we, you know, that they need to know that we are not people who see themselves, that we are sufficient for ourselves.
A služiti zajednici okolo nema, uzelo bi jedan sat kad bi se počelo opisivati na koje sve moguće načine to radi.
But serving the community, we could spend a whole lot of time describing in the kind of ways you can do service in the name of Christ to this community.
Odlično imati koncerte.
It's wonderful to have concerts.
Odlično imati događaj gdje se ovdje skupimo i uživamo zajedno.
And it's wonderful to have occasions where we get together and celebrate and serve each other in here too.
Ali ako poznajemo Krista,
but when we who know Christ and get to accept Christ,
onda moramo i ruke zaprljati služeći onima oko nas.
And then we need to get our hands dirty as we serve the community outside.
Onda moramo sudjelovati u njihovim agonijama, u njihovim problemima.
then we need to kind of partake and in some ways engage ourselves through all that they're suffering and what they're going through.
Jer jednostavno to je sve zajedno povezano.
Because in the end of the day, all of these things are connected together.
Jer biti sljedbenikom Isusa Krista nije samo biti u crkvi.
Being a follower of Christ is not just sitting in the church.
Nije samo čitati iz Biblije.
It's not just reading from the Bible.
Nije samo imati odlične programe.
It's not just having wonderful programs.
Nego poziva nas to i baciti se u prljavštinu ljudi s kojim se oni bore.
The invitation is actually to get down to where the people are and get into the dirt where they really are.
I onda posvjedočiti.
And then witness through that.
Ja sad s ovime završavam.
I'm now concluding with that.
A da vam samo jednu stvar kažem, jednu koju namjerno sam propustio sinoć za vas koji ste tu bili.
I just want to say one example, especially for those, I left that out, especially for those of you who remember last night who were here.
Kao ilustraciju.
As an illustration.
Sjećate li se kad sam govorio o tome, o grupi ljudi koja je bila u kukuruzima, dočekivala izbjeglice.
Remember, as I mentioned last night, about those people, refugees who we saw and met in the cornfields.
Na samoj granici između Srbije i Hrvatske, u mom slučaju sa srpske strane.
You know, on the very border between Serbia and Croatia, and in my case, I was on the Serbian side.
Sredina devetog mjeseca.
Middle of the ninth month.
Završetak kasnog ljeta, temperature 36 stupnjeva.
The conclusion of a very hot summer.
Prašina takva da možeš ju gutati.
The dust was thick that you could literally swallow it and eat it.
I tisuće njih grupe od stotinu dolaze jedna za drugom u razmacima desetak minuta.
And groups in their hundreds, you know, coming in waves one after the other.
I onda znate što nam govore?
And you know what they're saying to us?
Muslimani su.
They're Muslims.
Naši su nas zaboravili.
They used to say, ours have forgotten us.
A vi kršćani nas volite.
But you Christians love us.
To je ono kad kaže, izić van i zaprljati se.
That's that when I what I mean when I say going out of our comfort zone and being where the people are.
Imao sam i nekoliko biblijskih tekstova ovdje.
I had a few Bible texts as well.
Možda nije ni bitno, čuli smo ih i čućemo ih.
They're texts that we are familiar and we will hear them again, I'm sure.
Ali za mene ono što piše u Rimljanima u prvom poglavlju u 16. stihu.
But for me, that which was written in Romans chapter 1 and verse 16,
gdje kaže, ne stidim se evanđelja Kristovog,
where it says, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Jer je ono snaga Božja, da spasenje svakome tko vjeruje.
Because it's the power of God to save those who believe.
Ja to zadnje sve više razumijem da u praksi to izgleda da s jedne strane je držati se Krista.
And I want to put that more into the practice that in one hand you hold on to Christ,
a drugom baciti se u prljavštinu svijeta da bi bio svjedokom njegovim u toj prljavštini.
You go out into the community and kind of reach the people where they are.
Vjerujte me, ako to radimo, neće biti mjesta u crkvi uskoro.
Remember, if we do and if we evangelize in this way, there will not be rooms in our churches.
Evo, to je moja poruka.
That's our message for you. Amen.